Hello guys, and welcome in another video. This time I'm going to explain you all my V-bar control and V-bar settings. As you probably know, I've been flying helicopters for over 10 years now, so I have a long experience on how to set up the V-bar and the V-bar control. So this is my Logo 700, this is the competition machine and the event machine that I've been using for all these years. I've been flying with this helicopter in many different competitions, like 3DX China, the Worldwide Championship, the 3D Heli Master. And as you know, of course, I've been flying with this helicopter over here, that is the Logo 700, the new one, for a lot of years. And I have a lot of experience also with the mechanic and how it flies and everything. So I'm gonna explain you the basics of the V-bar, the basics of the V-bar control, and how to set up perfectly the Logo 700 with my setup. So it's really important, of course, to have the same servos that I have and to have the same things that I'm using. But if you actually have not the same setup but similar, I'm sure the settings is gonna be fine for you as well. This is a secret because I've never told to anyone how to set up my Logo 700, so this is gonna be really interesting to see what you think about my setup. So let's go into it. Just bouncing it. First of all, what do we have to do? We have to turn on our V-bar control and then turn on our helicopter. First, I have to take the canopy off. Okay, so this is without the canopy. And now I'm gonna plug battery. For example, right here, I've got my 6S 5000 milliamps OptiPower battery. I'm gonna use this one just to power up this helicopter. I'm using the Obi-Wing, as you know, the 160 HV. It has the VEC built-in, so it's gonna be very easy because I just need to plug the battery. It's gonna power up the servos and the V-bar. Damn, this blade is in my face. Let's move it here. There you go. Okay, let's plug it in. Okay, as you see, the V-bar control connected my helicopter. So as you can see right here, we have the name, that is Logo 700, the voltage of the receiver, that in this case is the V-bar. Then we have the banks, the motor off, the battery of the radio, that is 77%. We've got all the information we need, the timer, the clock, and the governor that I'm gonna explain later on. Okay, let's jump into the settings right now. Okay, so right now we can go in the first page. As soon as you click this button right here on the right side, that is the only button we have in the V-bar control, we can see different folders. We're gonna concentrate just on the settings of the model itself, so we're gonna go in the main rotor, that for me is the most important part of the setup. Into it we can find Expo, Style, Rate, and Gain. And then we have the Auto Trim and the Expert, that we're going to talk about them later on. What about the Expo? Okay, the Expo is the line that the control makes. So you can have a linear line, it means zero Expo. So when you give aileron, for example, or elevator or tail, whatever you want, the control is going to go direct, it's going to be direct, so it's going to be perfectly clean. If you have Expo, it's going to create a little S, this line. So you're gonna have a tiny movement, it's gonna increase even more toward the end. So if you have higher Expo, of course the helicopter is more precise in the center, and it's gonna be more agile in the end. This is the reason why I don't use a lot of Expo, and I don't use just a little bit, but I use 38, that is kinda in the middle. The style, I use 95. What the style does is the thrust that you give to the helicopter, to the V-bar. If you have a very high style, the V-bar is gonna control your helicopter very well, so it's gonna be a little bit more robotic and precise, and less agile. If you have less style, it's gonna be more up to you. So it's gonna give you the control of the helicopter and less to the V-bar, and it's gonna be a little bit less precise, but of course more agile. Let's move into the rates. Rate is really important. I'm using 128. This is a pretty high rate, considering that the maximum is gonna be around 200, so it's more than the medium. I'm using 128 because I really love to have super agile helicopter. So if you have a low rate, it's gonna rotate very slowly. If you have a high rate, it's gonna rotate faster. But you have to be careful, because if the rate is too high, then you can make boom strike with all the helicopters you want. It doesn't mean that the boom strike it's up to the helicopter if you have different brands. It's just about settings. So if you have super high rate in the main rotor, of course you're gonna do boomstrang with every helicopter you want. Alright, so the gain. Gain is the control that the V-bar has in the rotor head. So if you have a too high gain, it's gonna vibrate a little bit, the helicopter. When you give an input and you stop, the helicopter is gonna vibrate a little bit. And if it's too low, it's gonna wobble slowly. So you have to just do some tests and fly it and see what's the difference between a high and a low one and find the best between the high and the low. For this helicopter and these Savox Monster servos that you can see right here, I really love the 69. 69 is my best one. Okay, let's go into the out trim now. What do you have to do in the out trim? That at the moment I have zero because my helicopter is geometrically, talking about the geometry, is perfect and everything, so I don't need any out trim in this heli, but in different ones I do need it. Out trim basically is just making helicopter flying straight. So if you pirouette, the helicopter has to be straight. If while pirouetting the helicopter does a little bit of movement, then you have to increase the tail elevator or aileron out trim. The best thing to do is to have zero wind, turn on your auto trim over one minute, and then the auto trim is gonna be perfectly done automatically. Let's go into the other ones now. Okay, sorry for this stop, but I want to say a huge thank you to ISDT that gave me this wonderful battery checker that if you plug the battery into it, you can also charge whatever you want for like device, phones, cameras. In this moment, for example, I couldn't keep going and shooting this video because my camera was empty. But yeah, thanks to ISDT, I can charge this camera wherever I want. So in this moment, it's thanks to this little box that I'm doing this video. So thank you, ISDT. If we go in the next page, we have the expert. What is the expert? Expert are different parameters that you can either use or not use, and your helicopter is still flying good, but you can make it fly even better. So let's see what I'm using. Swoosh expert. I am using 10 as elevator precompensation. Then I have paddle simulation, usually it is around 10 or 20, I always put it down to 0. What paddle simulation is doing is simulating the paddles, so instead of the flybrothers, do you remember the paddles? I know it's quite old at the moment, but this is the paddle simulation. So if you have the paddles right here, the helicopter is actually going to be like a mechanic gyro, it's working like a mechanic gyro. So with the paddle simulation, it's gonna act and pretend to be like a real paddle. I always use that zero because I don't like it. I use the flybarless because I want the flybarless, so I don't want back the flybar. Heli size, 50 heli size, 60 integral is gonna be fine. Pitch pump, I always use it at zero pitch pump because I don't love it. If you have a heavy machine, because this is a really light machine, if you have a heavy machine like different other helicopters, then maybe you would need like 10 maximum. Cyclic ring, I use 85, if you use more, just make sure that your cyclic is okay. What cyclic ring is, if you move the elevator forward and on the left, or forward on the right, or forward on the back, the servo doesn't have to make any noise. Do you see right here? I am full elevator and full aileron, and the servos are quiet. This is when the cyclic ring is perfect. Optimizer, I use it 64 and it's really okay, and then if I put it at 64 then I turn off the optimizer. Let's keep going because I don't want to make this video super long. Tail rotor, I use 27 expo. The rate I'm using 138 as a speed. Tail gain is 77. I'm using the Savox Monster as I said, so 77 is perfect for me. Expert, tail optimize, I'm using the tail compensation of the Collective 22 and the tail compensation of the Cyclic is 8. I'm using those, I never touched them, and they work perfectly. For me, it's really important, the side A and side B, I use 19 and 60, and I leave it on. So I leave always the optimizer on, because if there are any changes or anything, it adjusts by its own, and it's perfect for me. Because if there is a little bit of wind in this competition, in this event, the tail is gonna compensate. So even if this on is on, it's gonna adjust on the condition of the hair, or of the weather and everything, so it's gonna be okay. Tail expert. 55 acceleration, ATP gain, I gain 60, I limit off, and always is perfectly as stock. Stop gain, it's really important for me to have the stop gain A up to 25, stop gain B 20, and then D gain 0, and I discharge off. This is all stock, except the stop gain A. Let's go into the other settings, these are almost the last ones. at speed. I always run with this helicopter, 1900, this is the lowest RPM I have. Then I have 2080, this is the medium, and 2200, this is my maximum RPM settings. I usually use 2180, and the governor gain for the obby wing is for me perfect 37. 37 is working the best for me. This is all stock, so I don't need anything to say about it. I don't have anything to say. Mode status not either. Main rotor is really important. So I have collective endpoint. I always put them in the same way. So what they do is 93, 93, and then set the geometry. I put 93 and 93, then I over with the helicopter, and the stick has to stay a little bit up, and then I over invert it, and the stick has to be a little bit down. The difference from the center, from that point of stick up and that point of the stick down, it has to be the same. If it is higher or lower, you just adjust the geometry of these links over here and you make it perfect, but never touch these ones. So these parameters have always to stay 93 and 93. Never do like 93, 87, stuff like this. Another important point is the cyclic setup, and I use 81. This is working the best for me. So I think that we told everything about it. We can go in the tail. As tail, it really depends on you, but I'm using 108 and 108. And in the governor endpoints, I'm using everything stock. I'm using the 14 pinion, 5 of sensor configuration, 20 of throttle, and run up limit at 3. And this is it. These are all my settings. Okay, this was a video of how the V-Bar works and of my settings of the V-Bar. But if you want a page with all the settings and everything that I have in my V-Bar control, I'm gonna put a picture right now. Okay, these are all my settings, you can just put them on your helicopter, create a bank, and tell me what you think in the comments down below in this video, and I'm gonna publish also this video with the link of YouTube on Facebook. Just be sure to go there and make sure to comment down below, like it and share it, and talk with your friends in the comment down below, tell me what you think, what you would change on my settings and everything you want. And also tell me if you like this kind of videos. If you want to see other videos like this one, just please tell me which helicopter you want to see. I still have the Logo 550, the Logo 480, the Logo 600. I have different helicopters like the Oxy and everything. So tell me which is the next helicopter that I should review, and I should do the settings review. So as I said, would be amazing for me if you give me a like down below, if you comment whatever you want, and please subscribe to my channels. Thank you very much, and see you in the next one. Peace. And of course, while I'm shooting and I have everything set up, I eat a fried meat.